Welcome back to another edition of the Cloud-Rending Quill. This is the August 2017 Patreon Poetry for Mythical Minstrelsy. I am Teresa Garcia, also known as Amehana Arashi, and these are the poems that were written for the month of August for my Patreon. This first one is called The Power of Silence. Do you know the power of silence? Why a witch chooses with care the words that leave her lips and her thoughts thus bare. Do you know the pyramid of power? To know, to dare, to will, to be silent above all. What good from being so still? What the witches know to be true focuses their power through action, saving the energy that would be lost and make the will lose traction. Why waste a word, a precious word, a piece of soul and sleeping spell? Keep it quiet, keep it calm, measured in beats as footsteps fell. Beneath your pacing feet through time, whether in circle working or outer land, dancing ever with the shifting tide flowing out of lady's silvered hand. Know that you will get there, achieve the goal you dare to dream, will yourself through the gate, unleashing the strength of the stream. But be silent with what you do, holding focus and choosing words, saving breath with steady steps. Be the calm within the storm. This next one is Night Rise. The night does not fall. She rises, drawing the cloak of stars with her as she walks. Before her comes the dusk, the twilight gloaming, radiating from her face, her smile shining. The moon rises at her command, another part of herself, seen by day and by night as she traverses the sky. Some days her aura is great, others it is small. The night walks the path that she always has, in the far north, in the far south. She lingers longer, combing her shining hair. There are those that say the night falls and the day sleeps. Neither falls. Both rise. Both weave their endless dance. The night rises, drawing her cloak and veil, swirling with the coolness, bringing forth starlit dreams, washing all in moonlit touch, soothing the burning ache of the exuberant sun deep within the night. The sun softly moves, lowered beneath the skirts, only to rise again when night, smiling, dips back in their waltz. Magpie. You see me in pairs, sometimes in threes, also by ones at times up in the trees, or down on the ground, I hop and I watch, as mankind passes on their march. In the east I am happy, my call brings luck, but those in the west associate me with muck. Joy and sorrow unite here within my breast, though I am just a bird, and am not your test. One for sorrow, two of us joy, but will you recall it on the coming morrow? I am black, I am white, I am love, I am fright. Come, point at me, call me vanity. Others see me and say, you should harder pray. I am the friend of the witch, carrying messages and giving cheer, but I rode the roof of a great boat here. Most don't know how we are used to being vilified, though we worked so hard to raise the waiting skies. I am just a simple bird, enjoying my time in the sun. I've earned my black, and my song is done. This next one was already recorded once as a single, but I'm going to record it again in the grouping itself for this month. So this is Forest Fire. One spark is all it takes. One spark a life takes. Stretching and spreading by day or by night, threading and wending through foliage bright, dry licking fingers, hungry for more, ever reaching to fill its core. With life, bright life, delicious and precious. More, more, despite what's in store. Finally standing tall at the peak of the pine, on the top of the ridge, crackling and roaring, all I taste is now mine. Valley to valley he stretches and fills, roasting the deer and choking fish gills. In the stream, the glorious stream, once flowing blue, now filling black, boiling beneath the heat of the fire spirit's gaze, wishing and crying for cooler days. Smoke, dark smoke, rolls and builds in the sky, sweeping over the mountains, a harbinger of doom, death on the wind, death on the land, flowing down the stream as only death can, devouring all that he can catch, until life pushes back at last. Dancing in his own domain, forest fire creates and calls the rain. Fire and water clash, causing lightning to flash, opposites entwined, loving the dance. Round about the edges the tribe of men play, doing what they can and may, to curb his power, his lust for life, kerchiefs tied against his musk. When he tries to slip fingers down into their lungs, while they yield pick, shovel, and McLeod, or water now tame and mild, drop from the sky as if he were a child, playing at water balloons. The fools, I'll burn them over, take their tools. Perhaps in their foiled tents I'll find a rent, then add them to me, I'll make the attempt. Wind now bends as the fire bids, driving fire over the men. Through their own hell the men persevere, thinking of their families living in fear, of the fire so near their doors. Let me see them just once more, each implores. To some force beyond mortal ken, as the fire burns over the men, and shadows fly home, so dark and black, walking through doors, visiting back, seeing in scenes unexpected and stark, on fearing hearts to leave new marks. Not a word can they say, but those at sea can't look away from husbands and lovers, fathers and brothers, who suddenly are gone, and know not to where, if back to preserved bodies, or up that climbing stair, or if they will come home again, if in color, in life, or as ashen death. Fire cares not, only dances and burns, more ancient than man, and laughing in mirth. Then, finally, he once more lays doom to sleep within the ground, and eventually wears a leafy, growing crown. Now, this last one for the month of August is a morning tonka, and it was written and posted first for the McLeodians group on Facebook. So, a morning tonka. The mountain rises into the morning sky, hearts swell, open, to the forest spread around, below a cloudy crown. And that ends the poems that were specifically for August. I hope that you enjoyed this recording. If you like my poetry, or if you like my meditation videos when I do get to put those out, or if you like my novels, or any of my other many projects, please consider visiting my Patreon, perhaps pledging. If you can't afford that, then please feel free to also like and share and subscribe and suggest me to your friends. I do enjoy interacting, so do please feel free to comment either here or on my Patreon or talk to me on my DeviantArt or over on Facebook or anywhere else that I can be found. And I will see you another time.